back to green. An extended caution. And a caution rule at the beginning. It was crazy. But we're now finally back green. And after that madness, somehow S-Class Warfare has caught all the way from last to first. That gray Mercedes is now your leader. Hurricane Train is second. Pink Camaro third. Blue one. FM50 in fourth. Sonic Chini using his air horn to try to squeeze on by. Pink Camaro now trying to grab Hurricane Train. That's also position. The top six are at Astro Roadhouse. That is in second place. Pink Camaro on the inside going for second place. Pink Camaro trying to fight the inside. She gets it. She gets it in second. Pink Camaro fighting her way to get to second place.
Team left before everything went wrong.
hooked in these fast cars are learning that robustness is faster than they are, more reliable than they are. And unfortunately for them, they are now falling back to position while Pink Camaro Hurricane Training Blue F-150 are your top three. That Blue F-150's reliability is holding it together, going into turn right now. First driver change. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a very, very important driver change. Pay close attention to the Pink Camaro pointing into the bench. Pay close attention to Hurricane Train. That is the Army looking green that's pulling in right now. Hurricane Train's getting in earlier. That's the pivotal pit stop. This is another lazy doctor outfit. Pink Camaro is not yet in their pit. Big strategy. They're pulling across the pits. Pink Camaro hasn't pulled in yet. Hurricane Train, if they get the fast stop, they can take huge advantage of this. Meanwhile, Van Gogh. Van Gogh already pitted. Pink Camaro on his way out. Clear the track. And a ton of cars make it out of the pit. Pink Camaro is able to stay ahead of Hurricane Train. But Van Gogh took a great advantage pulling earlier. They gained the lap back. They moved up a spot. That was a madness pit stop there. But just about anything that could happen happened. And all the teams, the top five, out of here. Pink Camaro, I don't even know how it happened. Blue F-150, I think, took him out. They're going to need a grid there for Blue F-150. I do think that's a grid penalty. That is a big grid penalty. Blue F-150 taking out the leader. That is a huge penalty for them. You can't take out the leader like that. He's forcing him to detail his car. He's washing all that dirty driving. He's got to wash it off. Yeah, they're making him clean the car. A penalty for roughing the leader. Yeah, that penalty cost him at least a lap and a half. That was a hard collision. I was struggling of all places. That knocked Blue F-150 down too far. Oh no, Carson! Carson's out! Somehow, the driver is no longer in the orange cart. Orange cart, what happened? It's Leo now! Leo's broken off of it! I don't know how terminal that is, but that's pretty bad. Orange cart now pushed it, pulling in. Oh, the huge collision, Carson's out! Now F-150 again puts Super Bug. How many more grid penalties does F-150 want today? I don't know, Grim. How many you want to give them for that? F-150's already pretty quick over the number of grid penalties it racks up for hitting everyone. They might not be quick yet. Orange Box is able to get back out. Robbins just keeps himself. Needs to be pushed in there. Has to be pushed in. Just push it in. Patrick, how much damage do you think Pink Camaro took from that hit? Pink Camaro, your leader. That radio flyer number 414 convention is now in second. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, that much has happened. The top three has rotated like five times with five different cars at this point. And the fishing is settled right in. Oh no, Rafael now pulling over. Caution for Rafael, they were in sixth place before that incident. Unicorn cart, by the way. In all the madness of the fast, the cart is now on trip four. Milwaukee Lakers faces Unicorn, is now fourth place. Corpus Corrales is back out there racing without a body, which means they're also racing without a trans popper. Oh no, speaking of body loss, the ice cream truck just lost everything. It has no body left. That was perfectly timed by that ice cream truck, Captain. Unicorn cart now in fourth place, blew up 150 in fifth. Super Bowl in sixth, Alexa Kool-Aid by the way, Captain, finally moving the ball to second place. Oh no, arms cart spinning around. A lot of wheel rub, I think, from the leader there. I heard it's fancy. That's really running against the body of the car. Really at the first stint and already in the lead in the Tampa coast. This is 75-minute endurance race. And it is chaotic to say the absolute least. Oh, that was body rub from Setback. Setback currently in ninth place. Oh man, so many. Patrick, just like in the previous race, there's so many random noises from these cars. Before you try to figure out what to run from under you, another car giving you another normal turn on the nose. Pink Camaro making its way through the field in the lead. Convention, F-150 into the wall, backing its way out. Gotta get going. It does get going. While the field now, absolutely mad and behind the cars crunching and grinding, cars beginning to snow thoroughly at this point. You can hear the noise coming from these machines. Two wheels of F-150 goes into turn one. So here we go, which had two issues earlier, is now 12 for 51 laps complete. There is a lot of racing left, folks. And we've already seen some of our fastest cars completely lose everything. And they're back out. They fixed early break, except for S-Class. I'm not sure what happened to S-Class. Oh, it looks like orange. Yep, orange cart. For the third time, the pole sitter, the orange cart now pulling into the pits, being pushed back to the pits. Orange cart had a great start, rapidly fell apart, it's already in 14, way, way back there. It was the whole same car.
Again, having more problems.
Even run.
Ha ha.
The caution was coming in at the center of the infield because they had a tangent to barriers. Patrick, the mid-track is an absolute mess right now. I'm trying to get to the S-Lock to find out what happened. Mercedes. And so he's running up and yelling to us. What happened?
But how?
The Cleveland? They have no problem. It's gone. Do you have it there?